It's the awe-inspiring new series, taking a deep dive into parts unknown. Using advanced technology, the producers of BBC America's Planet Earth, Blue Planet 2, were able to explore the world beneath the ocean's surface like never before. New environments discovered. An underwater lake of toxic brine and sulfur surrounded by a flourishing ecosystem.
The cure for cancer could lie right beneath us in this brine.
So, Ola, what is different about this series?
I think what we've really done is try to tell unbelievably surprising and new stories from the ocean. The ocean is such a giant, giant part of our planet, and really it's still so unexplored and we're still just scratching its surface.
Ola Doherty and Mark Brownlow spent 4 years on the project.
We spent an unprecedented 6,000 hours underwater filming never-seen-before behaviours, but on top of that, we also spent another 1,000 hours in deep-sea submersibles, exploring new worlds in the ocean's deep abyss.
What was your favourite part?
For me, it was the day that we filmed this methane volcano. So we went down to see something we weren't quite sure what we were going to see. It's like I went to another planet that day and came back to Earth to tell people about this extraordinary world.
Filming on every continent, in 39 countries, across every ocean.
To see what a whale sees is going to be very exciting.
Cameras attached to suction caps placed on these whales.
Tag on!
Following their every move.
Whoa!
We were very keen to find a way to give the audience the experience of what it would be like to ride on the back of a killer whale. And we worked hand in hand with these inspiring scientists up in Norway.
Oh my God!
Behind the scenes, hungry sharks reminding the crew that this is their territory. Humans are foreigners here, battling it out against each other.
They're fighting each other!
Over a whale carcass and the crew's submarine.
Look at this underneath.
Oh, gross.
Oh, he's pushing us!
Oh.
Move away.
Go!
And they were bumping at the sub?
Six gill sharks moved in and got very territorial about this big dinner. But once they realised, no, actually that's a big yellow electronic thing, that's not a big yellow animal, then they carried on just getting on with it.
Mobular rays, filmed in complete darkness, feasting on glowing plankton.
New camera technology, new diving technology, and more importantly, or just as importantly, a new understanding of ocean life has enabled us to take the audience to new worlds and reveal never seen before behaviours.
Producers followed these tuskfish for 6 weeks.
Fish have definitely got personalities.
Like Percy, a clever fish, using coral to crack open a golf-sized clamshell with his tiny mouth. But it was the Humboldt squid catching producers off guard.
We were capturing behaviours we didn't even know were going to happen until we got down there. They will hunt wherever they can. These are hungry animals. There's this tug of war goes on between one squid that's caught another squid because they do eat each other. There's this whole sort of cannibalistic fight that went on at 950 metres off the coast of Chile.
While the series captures fascinating behaviours of underwater creatures and the beauty below, it also highlights the effects of global warming and pollution on ocean life. Increasing temperatures wreaking havoc on coral reefs, home to one quarter of all marine species. And in Sarasota Bay, dolphins' calves are dying.
There's a high mortality rate among firstborn calves, and this could be due to inexperienced moms or other factors, but it's higher than what we would expect, and clearly there's something else going on.
An estimated 8 million tons of plastic are dumped into the ocean each year, contaminating the waters, which could be causing the decline in dolphin populations.
After only trawling for 20 minutes, this is what we're pulling out of the water. So while these things look tiny, they can leach these toxins and contaminants into the water.
The series already having a royal impact. The Queen banning plastic straws and bottles. Buckingham Palace outlining a new waste plan.
We are at a crossroads right now. It's not too late to choose the future we want.
Do you think hopefully maybe it's changed people's ideas about what they can do in their own homes?
It's really important to us that people do feel they come away with it, thinking, oh, I can do something.
There's a Native American phrase, we don't inherit the earth from our ancestors, we borrow it from our grandchildren. And for me, that really strikes a chord. Everybody can do little things, and those little things add up, and collectively they make a huge difference.
For many people, the oceans are out of sight, out of mind. What we wanted to do was make people fall in love with the oceans. We wanted people to recognize that actually we're more closely connected to the oceans than we thought possible.
For Nightline, I'm James Longman in London.
The finale of Blue Planet 2 airs tomorrow on BBC America.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.